When you use a task group for the first time, there's one mistake that's very easy to make. Luckily, it's usually quite easy to notice that the code isn't behaving as we would expect. But it can be tricky to understand what's actually causing the problem. So let's have a look at this piece of code and take it step by step. I've implemented an asynchronous function that fetches some data, and I'm making the function sleep for a random amount of time before returning its result. This way, the function simulates the behavior of a network call that would also take an unpredictable amount of time before returning its result. Then I'm creating a task group, and in this task group, I add several tasks, each of them making a call to fetch data and returning the result. Finally, I collect all the results in an array, and I return that array. At first glance, everything looks good. But if we print the array to the console, we'll see that the order of its values isn't what we would have expected. The order seems to be completely random, and it actually is. What's happening, and what's key to understand, is that when we collect the results, we collect them in the order in which the tasks have returned them, and not in the order in which the tasks had been created. So what do we do if we want to have the results in the same order that the tasks were created? The most versatile approach is to slightly tweak the tasks that we create so that instead of just returning the result of fetch data, they now return a tuple with both the argument passed to fetch data and its result. And from there, once we've collected all the results, we can now use this extra piece of information to order them correctly. Of course, depending on the situation, you can adapt this approach to add to the tuple any other value that you need to correctly order the results. That's all for this video. I hope you've enjoyed discovering and understanding this common pitfall when using a task group. As always, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss the next ones. Thank you for watching and see you next time.